This is a tour of the major blood vessels of the body. We're going to start at the superior end. So this is the head. The common carotid artery takes blood to the head, and the internal jugular vein takes blood away from the head. We have the heart. Blood is pumped out the heart through the aorta. It's the largest artery in the body. And then it branches. So here's the vertebral artery. And then it's going to branch also to the right side. So we have the right subclavian artery. It is coupled with the right subclavian vein. So arteries take blood away from the heart. We have the axillary artery. It's in the armpit. It's coupled with the axillary vein, taking blood back to the heart. The brachial artery. Brachial means arm, so the brachial artery is taking blood down the arm. The brachial vein is taking it back to the heart. Down in the forearm, we have the ulnar artery. It's on the ulnar side. This is the ulna bone. We have the common interosseous artery. It's in between the ulna and the radius. And then we have the radial artery on the radial side, because this is the radius. And then we have the superficial palmar arch in the hand. So blood is being brought back to the heart through the superior vena cava. It's going to drain the upper limbs and the head. And then blood will flow through half of the heart and then be pumped out to go to the lungs through the pulmonary trunk. The pulmonary trunk is carrying deoxygenated blood, and it's going to branch. So we have pulmonary arteries that are going to go to the left side, and the pulmonary arteries that will go to the right side. Blood goes to the lungs, it does gas exchange, and becomes oxygenated. It comes back to the heart through the pulmonary veins. So pulmonary means lungs, veins means it's coming back to the heart. And then as it goes through this left side of the heart, it will be pumped out through the aorta. So the aorta is carrying oxygenated blood. So down in the abdominal cavity, we have the celiac trunk. We have the hepatic vein and common hepatic artery. Hepatic means liver. We have the supramesenteric veins as well as the supramesenteric artery. We have the splenic artery and the splenic vein. So we have, this is the spleen here. We have the renal artery and the renal vein. Renal means kidney. This is the abdominal aorta that travels through the abdomen. We have the inferior mesenteric artery. We have the common iliac artery and the common iliac vein. We have the external iliac artery and the external iliac vein. Then we have the internal, because they're more internal, iliac artery and internal iliac vein. Going down the leg, we have the femoral artery, because this is the femur. The artery is still taking oxygenated blood away from the heart in the leg. Then we have the posterior tibial artery. So this is the tibia. So posterior means it's behind. Then we have the anterior tibial artery because it's on the front side of the tibia. And we have the dorsal artery of the foot. The great saphenous vein is often used if we need a piece of blood vessel. And then also on the foot, we have the dorsal venous arch. It's on the dorsal side of the foot. It's in the shape of an arch. It's carrying deoxygenated blood, so it's venous.